this tutorial, I will show you how to create a particle system based on the animated FBX file. I think first we have to import our FBX file. I'll use a butterfly that I've downloaded from the sketch file. I'll dive into the component to see what's the error that I get. Well, that's just a texture that needs to be re-uploaded, but in this case I'll just delete the whole node, as we don't need textures here at all. Let's get the geometry file with import select SOP and connect these components by dragging our FBX to import parent field. To define geopath, we go inside our FBX component again and find the component with geometry. You may have different layout here, just search for geometry and don't confuse it with the animated joints component, which looks somewhat like this. We need just a single SOP with static mesh. We need to copy geopath from this mesh to our recently added import select SOP. Pass the copied geopath to the import parent field of the import select component. Now you should see a mesh. We've just referenced to it, but it doesn't have any animation, so let's add the deformed SOP and drag our FBX component to the skeleton root path parameter. And now the butterfly is flying. I will just slow it down a bit. Butterfly, go to the play tab. I'll reduce the speed to my taste. Now I see that the animation is not perfectly looped, but I can fix it by turning the trim on and adjusting the end of the animation. Have a look at your geometry. In my case, it's positioned not in the center of coordinates, so I'll go to FBX component, X form tab, and I will lower the butterfly to 6.5. I highly recommend you to keep your files in the center of coordinates. It will be easy to work with them later. Add Sprinkle SOP. It will evenly distribute points from our geometry. I'll increase the amount of points to 12,000. It can be more or less. Now let's keep it for a while and add a particle system. Go to the palette, Tools, ParticleGPU. Drag it to your workspace. Now we want our particles to spawn from our geometry, right? The first input of the particles component is particle source. That's where we should connect the components. But particle source input is top, which means that we should feed it with texture. So all we have to do here is to convert our data. We can't convert SOP to top directly, so we have to convert SOP to chop first. After that, we go to top and select chop to. Then change data format to RGB. What we've just done is basically we've took our geometry point, extracted position data of each point, and then put this position into RGB values. Let's connect our components. Now select the particle component, change heat behavior to none, and turn off the display bounds. Let's adjust particles to see the butterfly. First of all, I'll replace leaves with circles. Go to the mat, constant, then add circle top. We define the texture of the material in the color map stroke. Drag our circle there. Then turn on the transparency in the common tab. Now we select particle GPU, go to the material tab, and set the material to custom. Then drag our custom material below. The next thing I'm gonna do is go to Forces tab, reduce all the functioning forces for 0 for now, and set rotation type to face camera. Then let's go to the particles GPU to adjust some parameters there. Let's make the life type random, let it be in between 1 and 3 with life variance 0.5. Set burst to 30,000 particles per frame. I'll also decrease the particle size. Now go to the particle source tab and turn off points interpolation. It's a very important step. So now we can distinguish the butterfly, but I would like to visually separate its body from its particle spin room, and I'll do it with color. If you go to the render tab, you'll see that particle's color is set to constant. Let's change it to 80. We can see that colors are taken from the null color operator. Dot slash means that this operator is located inside of the component. But before we go there, let's add some forces. I'll add turbulence to make a wavy motion. And also an external force to make it move a bit backward. Now let's put a render on a separate screen. First, insert RGB key top to fill the background, and then null. Split the screen in two sections. On the right, we'll choose top viewer. On the left, right click display, deselect background tops. I'll also make the screen vertical to have a better view. Now let's dive into ParticleGPU component to set colors. So we need to find null color, Ctrl plus F and type null color. What we see here is that this chirp defines RGB values, which are converted to top further. And then go to the glsl shader. So actually what we can do is to set colors here. Simply create a ramp top. We want it to be the same resolution as this top, 120. Let's set some contrast color just to get the idea of what we're going to do. Connect your ramp to the color lookup. The color that you see on the right side of the ramp is the color of a young particle. So they're born white, then smoothly become red. What I want to do is to set the particle white at the beginning of their lifetime and then fade them away to distinguish the body, and then make them colorful again. That's the place where you can experiment to get the result that you like. Let's go to the particle's GPU, find size and change this to age. When we changed colors, we were redirected to the null color lookup, so the same goes with size. Go inside and type null size. So actually it's a pattern size that defines size. Let's tweak it. Decrease the amplitude to 1, offset 0 from range 0 to 1, and 2 range will define the actual size, so let it be 0.3 to 0.05. Now we have bigger particles in the beginning of the lifetime, and then they become smaller. So that's pretty much it. Let's make a basic post-processing. First, I'd like to decrease alpha to avoid overexposure. Then I'll add bloom top and level top right after. And the final thing that I want to do is just to rotate our butterfly. I'll do it in the X tab of the FBX component. I'll write a very basic Python script to rotate the butterfly. So that's it. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you have any questions or suggestions, leave them in the comments and I will consider it while making the next tutorial.